there's gonna come a day. And I swallow because, you know, I'm a little nervous about that day, but it's okay. It's okay. I know it's higher than myself. Hello everyone and welcome back to The Lifestyle. I am Chanel Smith and I am back with another video for you guys. But first thing is first, I am almost to 100 subscribers. That's such a big deal for me because y'all don't even understand, we've come a mighty long way. But with that being said, if you're new, make sure you share this video and tell your friends to subscribe to the channel. Turn on your notifications. You don't want to miss a thing. Sidebar, major update. I am 17 days away from my wedding. I'm getting married, y'all. And this is such a big deal. It's crazy, it's a little hectic, but it's beautiful, it's amazing, and I'm super, super excited. So with that being said, I definitely wanna get into some wedding videos. I have a whole bunch of stuff ready for you guys. I have some cake tasting videos, I have some wedding dress shopping videos, I have a video of me and my fiance coming up. So please make sure you turn on your notifications so you can be aware when that drops. With that being said, let's get into today's video. So today we're gonna talk about being bold. As I was scrolling down my timeline this week, I noticed that a lot of people were dropping their testimonies and I was like,
yes sis, drop that testimony.
We need to hear this, the world needs to hear this. Like there's so much freedom and there's so much power in your testimony. But anyways, I'm watching their videos or their blogs or their posts about their testimony and what God had delivered them from. Like they were proclaiming God's glory, like so bold, so confident. And it was so amazing because the things that they were talking about were controversial topics. And as we know, when you're talking about controversial topics and you're talking about things that God has delivered you from or brought you out from, and this is what God is leading you to say to people, God is leading you to tell people that they don't have to be in bondage, that you'll get some pushback. Obviously, if everyone took the time to boldly tell their testimony, so many people would be getting set free. So many people will see that they're not alone. So I want to encourage you all to be bold and courageous. So, transparency moment. It's so funny because I feel like all of my transparency moments are like about starting this YouTube channel back up. And it's just interesting how God uses that. Before I started my YouTube channel back up, in the process of, you know, God convicting me of not being obedient in continuing this channel when he told me to, one of the very many reasons that I was so skeptical about starting my YouTube channel back up is because I had some type of clue of what God wanted me to do. And when I say that, for people who may be like me, and God has shown you just maybe like a glimpse of what he has in store for you and what he has called you to do, he kind of has you count up the cost with that, and you do count up the cost and you're just like, it's real expensive, Jesus. Yeah, the thing that God has called us to, it's not necessarily an easy journey. It's not necessarily an easy word to give. And so I know me. I know the things that God has put in me. I know the things that God has revealed to me. And I know that the things that I have to tell the world aren't always gonna be easy. Now, so far you guys have seen all these encouraging videos from me and these fun videos from me, and that's great, that's fine and dandy, it's wonderful. But there's gonna come a day, and I swallow because, you know, I'm a little nervous about that day, but it's okay. It's okay. But there's gonna come a day where God is going to have me to speak out about controversial topics. He's gonna have me to speak against something that might not be the popular view. He's gonna have me to speak up and expose things that people may not want exposed. And I understand that that's a hard thing to do. I understand that that's going to take a lot of killing my flesh and being obedient to Christ to do, because it's not easy, especially being a person who is sociable. It's not easy to ruffle feathers all the time, even though I'm okay with it. I'd rather please God than please man, and that's just point blank period. But with that, you have to be bold and courageous to carry out the call on your life. The world will never be on your side. The world will never give you their vote, because you're doing what's not favored. You're doing things that go against the norms of this world. But like I said in many videos ago, we are to set new norms. We need to set the standard for this world. We have dominion and we have power over the enemy in Jesus' name. Backlash may come, persecution may come, ridicule may come. But at the end of the day, when you're standing before the Lord, do you think that all those people that ridiculed you, that talked against you, or even the people that rooted for you, do you think those people are going to be answering for your actions, for the things that you were obedient for, or the things that you were disobedient for the things that you spoke up for, or the things that you kept silent for in front of God? No, they won't be there to hold account for that. And so at the end of the day, even though it's hard, even though it's rough, even though it takes some dying to your flesh, even though there is a cost attached to it, and it is an expensive cost, it is a cost that Jesus paid his life for, you still have to do it. You still have to be obedient. Sometimes we sit back and we say, God, I didn't ask for this. And while that may be true, I'm pretty sure you said,
Lord, I want to be a willing vessel. Lord, I want you to use me. God, I'm here for your glory.
And when you said that, when you decided to pick up your cross and walk with Christ, that's what you signed up for. So it's like, do I people please today and gain the favor of men, or gain the likes of men, or gain the friendship of men? Or do I die to my flesh and please God and be obedient to what he's telling me to do and store up my treasures in heaven? It's so much reward in your obedience, and you have to remember that. So I pray for you and me that when the time comes where Jesus comes to us and says, I need you to proclaim my word. I know it's not easy. I know it's not fun. I know that it's not popular, and you may get some lashback because they didn't like me. So what makes you think that they're gonna like what you have to say if it's coming from me? I really pray that we will be bold and we will be courageous and we will stand for Christ, whether it's easy or not. I want to stand with you guys. Comment below in the comment section if you have been praying for boldness and courage, or even if you want to start. I will be here to intercede for you guys, because I know how important it is, especially in the times that we live in, that we don't fall into fear. We don't fall into wanting to just be in the middle of the crowd and not stand out, but how important it is for us to be bold and courageous in the things that God has called us into, and pray and fast even if you need to. And you know what time it is. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel. Again, we're trying to get to 100 subscribers, and then after that, 1,000,000. Who knows what God can do? And don't forget to turn on your post notifications, because I will be posting and posting and posting. Now, I'll let you guys know if I skip a week, because you know my wedding's coming up, so be on the lookout for that. But also, as always, share this video. I know that this is a timely word, because this is something that has been impressed upon my heart, and so many people are afraid to just tell their testimony, or simply tell someone about Jesus. And don't you forget, we're just like you. We just think different. I can do this myself.
is the God that has it.